Hello again, the 11 April 2011. Here on TV, there is a gentleman.
Some effects on nuclear, the atomic power policies of the world. What do you have to say about this area? There is a problem about accepting the easiness of accepting the nuclear policies. And even though we may want to depart from nuclear power, it doesn't change the situation about the reserves of the fossil fuel. And it is still costly to use fossil fuel. And we would like to discuss this part in our conference scheduled for June. And we will make our efforts, and we want Japan to do their efforts too. Thank you.
Sorry, because I could not record it all. You know, I don't know why, but my computer is very slow recently, and you know, the time to bring the camera and to start. And you probably hear that the sound of my video is very bad now, because I think my camera is letting me down. Well, you see this guy from the IAEA, Japanese guy. He was alive from Vienna a few minutes before I started to record. He said himself, you know, this big company, International Agency of Security Atomic, he is talking for them. He said that this problem is now affecting the world. Hello, it is now affecting the world. Who is pro-nuclear today? As I said previously, those who are pro-nuclear today are weak. You are not a patriot in your country if you are pro-nuclear. There is no fucking way you are pro-nuclear today. Your families are not endangered now around Fukushima plant. Your children are not gonna die next year from irradiation. You have no right to be a pro-nuclear today. Look, even this guy, the International Agency Security blah 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 atomic, my ass, even them, they admitted today that this is worse than 3 miles island. 1 month after, only they admit that this is worse than 3 miles island, and they continue to say, well, it's not a Chernobyl like scenario. But what's the difference between Chernobyl and Fukushima? Let me tell you, because so far everything I have said was true. It's confirmed on all the news every day after I said. Let me tell you the difference between Chernobyl and Fukushima. In Chernobyl, only one reactor exploded. So yeah, that was big. But here at Fukushima, we have 4 reactors and possibly 6, but 4 at least, you know, without to make any remorse. We have 4 reactors that you have seen, they have exploded. These reactors are melting slowly. They spread fucking radiation all over the world every day, and this will continue for months. The International Agency of Security Atomic said today that we've reached a dangerous level for the world. For the world. Where are you living? In which country are you living? Are you a pro-nuclear? Why are you a pro-nuclear? Are you a single man or a single woman? Are you not married? Don't you have a family? Don't you have children? Look at me. Look at me. And in my eyes, you can see the people around Fukushima power plant. Look inside my eyes. You can see these people, these women with babies, these women with children. You can see these men, these husbands with children. We have no other choice today than accept the fact that their children will probably die because of Fukushima power plant. Look at me. Are you a pro-nuclear?
Are you? We have to shut down the... It's too late. It's too late. Everything is too late. They talk it about it. They make it official today. They enlarge the security shelter around Fukushima. But come on. What are they enlarging? The radiation are recorded in USA today. In China. Chinese people, are you watching my videos? Do you think in China you are safe? Honestly, the radiation goes to USA. Don't you think you have some in China, in Korea, in Taiwan? Tell me, do you think so? No, I know you don't think so, because you know the truth. The truth is the stuff is going everywhere in the world. No, we have to fight the nuclear. We have to fight with non-violence. But if the nuclear industry doesn't learn anything from this, we are going to have to fight severely.